Hello guys, I got the camcorder out, and for the first time this year, we're going to start on this guy's tractor, and our famous sidekick is laying down on the job back there, so, yeah, first things first, we got to do front tires. Then I got to dismantle the front end because the front axle's broke on it. This is a customer's tractor. It's been in here before. I actually sold it to him. So let's get started. I gotta get everything set up. Hello guys. I know what you guys are gonna say. Being on your knees is gonna hurt your knees in the later life. Yeah, I know. They're already messed up. So, let's get these tires on. You guys may recognize these rims. They were off the Onan tractor. That's all right. Now, yes, these rims are rusty, but they're okay because these are tube tires. So I ain't worried about it. He can't use the rims that he has on the front because they're too wide. These ones are from my stash. And the same guy that owns this tractor bought the Onan tractor, and I still have to get that thing running correctly. A few years ago, I sold another Onan tractor to a buddy of mine, sight unseen. He basically, well, he did look at it, but he just got it running, and he gave me all kinds of pointers and tips, so we'll be copying some of those tips. Darn, I forgot to grab something out of my shed. So, we'll be pausing the video for a minute. Okay. Make sure you guys can see, because I see it's out of picture. So these tires are D-Stone tires. They came off of eBay. I showed the guy what he needed to buy, because he likes dry ribs. So, these tires come with tubes. Depending on what brand you buy, you get different brands of tubes. These are Kenda tubes. I'm not a fan of Kenda tires, so I'm not sure about their tubes. But their tires don't last. So, I'll pick that up later. Made in Taiwan, so you know it's got to be good. Flash. Let's see where Flash is. Flash. I try to keep an eye on the poor little guy. He wanders all over the place. So, we put the valve stem through here, and I do the same thing that Terrell does. Actually, this is where I got the tool from. He gave me one. Can't wait to get the tire machine done sooner or later, but that's on the back burner. Okay, let me get this aired up, because my air compressor is in the shed over here. Because I got two air compressors, that one that I picked up last year. Okay guys, I got the one done. So let me do the other one off camera and then we'll start on the tractor itself. As you can see, width wise it looks good. It's not all poofed out. So this is a good rim to use for that, because those rims that are on it would have been too poofy. It would have been spread out too much. Okay guys, let me explain to you how we're going to do this. We're going to do exactly like I did to the 80 that we did it a while back. We're going to drop the spindles out. After pulling the tires, I'm going to set the spindles on something like the old tires so they don't get into the dirt. Take the steering link out, but this one has something different. This front frame is bent, so I'm going to have to get a piece of pipe and a hammer and try to smack that back into place. So let's get started. I mean, I'm not going to show you how to beat on the frame though. And for anybody wondering, that's what it's doing. That front axle is broke. Oh. first things first. Let's get the tires off. Put that down. Okay, I'm just looking at everything. Now, if you remember right, the greaser has to come out in order to get the spindles out. Done. Now we go over here to the middle and disconnect the center link. You know what? That frame ain't bent. That bolt came loose, and that's why that axle started moving around a little bit. Without the supports there, it broke. And that's why on these customs you need to run the supports when you run the snowplow. Now, if you don't take this bolt out like this, you won't get the enough clearance to drop this spindle out. And yes, I could have moved it to where I had more room. This is not only the work we're doing to it, where you gotta fix the recoil again. Oh, there's the screwdriver, I just had it. And you know how I said get that, keep that from going into the dirt, and what did I do? Almost got it into the dirt. I don't believe he greased his front wheels. This guy has a lot of health issues now. So I'm just trying to help them out. Of course, I got a lot of health issues too, so. I'll just wipe these off before we put them back together. Better off to do that anyway. Yeah, that bolt is loose. It walked out. So that's the reason why that axle broke. Other than not having the supports. The bolt came loose. Yeah, it broke right where they normally break. This axle's not repairable. Like the one that came out of that other one, the tube broke free from the axle. This one snapped right off. So this one unfortunately is not fixable. I've tried fixing these when they snap like that. Nope. So they usually don't line up correctly and they will snap again. And I had somebody who actually welded good did one. It still did the same thing. The only success I had was replacing the tube. And even then that was a pain to get it back lining up. Okay, so let's see if I can get this thing pulled together correctly. All right. It so it's nice and tight, which is fine. This engine also has some blow by, which I told the guy not to worry about. Just add oil when it needs. Because it's very hard to rebuild one of these aluminum bores at times, because they almost always need bored. And well, this one could have used being bored. Another thing is, oh yeah, that drew it right up. That if I was to do one for a tractor again, I would take it to a machine shop and have them put a cylinder wall in it. A cast iron sleeve, I mean. It's nice, good, and tight. We gotta remove the grease zerks that are in this axle. Where did I take and put the wrench? Probably over on this side. I do have a belt on, guys, it's just that this stuff, this bending over and stuff, it don't work good. Okay, one greaser out. And the other one out. Okay, move this back over into place. Like so. Oh shoot, I need to wipe this off. Okay. All right. The washer and that, and then the greaser. Wipe it off. This guy here really puts this tractor through a lot of work, and it's, well, you know, been through the ringer once or twice. Originally, I got this tractor from a mower junkyard I used to work at. It had a bent axle on it. It was from Chicago. So, And yes, that steering link is bent, but I'm not worried about it. Like I said, this guy doesn't have a lot of money, so he wants things fixed kind of on the cheap side, so. I sold him this front axle. He was going to do it himself. Then his medical got worse, so. He brought it to me and says, here, do it. Okay. So, basically, this tractor is a 1973 st10, and it had no hood and grill when I got it. So, I assembled it up, I modified it, it's got the toolbox. And this was the first one I did where I put a toolbox on a custom. What did I do with that wrench? Oh, it's inside the tire. You were really good. Like I said, you can drill out that entire pipe out of the center and replace it, but when you're like me and have a bunch of parts, why? And another thing, yeah, I could bend that straight, but every time you bend something like that, you weaken it. So, I'm not touching it. Who knows, the next time it bends, it might snap. So, that's why I'm just leaving it alone. Like on my 8, I actually made up new tie rods. my knife one that I did for, well, that was after Dad died that the tie rods went out. So I just did what I could. Pine trees attacking me. So let's get the grease gun and go through the front end. There's no grease zerk on the axle pivot itself on this style. Come on, get on there. Okay, let's get it back onto the ground and see how it steers. I'm gonna pause the camera. Okay guys, it's back on the ground. Steers really nice. I see something, a problem. A bolt is loose. And I didn't touch it. Anyway, but all right, on to the next. Okay guys, so to get this recoil blower cover off, I have to take the off the side cover. So let's get to it. Alright, let's see. I want to say we did this the last time it was here too. down here. Okay, so this was one of my homemade jobs. All right, let's see. Guys also straight piped it too, so, which I think I've said before, so that probably doesn't help much. Come on. Is there one in the front? Yes, there is. This is the hard part on these engines, getting the lower shroud bolts off on when you put an 8-horse Briggs on these. Thank you. this bar has to come up. And what do we have behind door number one? I didn't want to have to do that, but it looks like I'm going to have to. Or maybe not. We got a mouse nest. Or starts of one. Yeah, he was in here chewing on the wire for the kill. So yeah. Alright guys, I'm gonna clean this up, tape up the wire. This needs lubed. Then we'll start putting it back together. I'll shoot some lube inside of here. Seems all right. Okay guys, I couldn't find my PB blaster, which I usually use. So we'll just have to make do with some knockoff spray. I forgot the air blower. So, this doesn't appear to be a full-length mouse nest. He got the coil wire, too. Looks like he was just trying to set up home and was interrupted, so I ain't too concerned. Doesn't have to be perfect. This has to cover up the wire so it won't ground out on anything. So that's good enough. And I know this thing ran. It ran when I parked it here. So, that should do it. that back on. Okay. Alright. So. We leave that loose. Actually, I want to put one of these longer ones up here, take the shorter one to put it down in the bottom. I know the battery's dead on this unit because it needs a new battery. He's aware of it. He's like, well, I don't want a full start. Okay. It would pull out, but it wouldn't go back in. Okay, I know what I have to do. Well, he's gonna need a new drive belt soon. Sun really messed this thing up. Thank you. I fight with this one bolt on it. All of them. Oh, come on. Oh. Well, instead of letting you guys sit there and watch me struggle with this, I'm gonna put it in off camera. Alright guys, I got it in. That was not fun. So now I'm tightening up the others. The guy says the RPMs are too high, but you know, I set this with a digital tack, so the last time I had it. So I'll have to listen to it and see. But I'm pretty sure it's fine. But if not, then it will have to go back over to Terrell's so I can use the digital tack on it. Because I'm pretty good at getting them close just by ear. You're going to blow it up by running over RPM. Dude, it's not even reaching max RPM. bottoms are... Okay. So now this can go back there. This can go on like that. That can go on the ground for now. These can go on the ground for now, along with this. Check the oil. Not even touching the stick hardly. So we'll have to put some oil in it. Let me find some. Okay, I'm putting 30 weight oil in it. Still needs more. Something's been chewing on the steering wheel because I put the steering wheel on this thing. I bought one off of eBay when I had it, and something's been chewing on the rubber. Because that wasn't a real nice looking steering wheel. Just a little bit more and it should be good to fire up. So it took almost a half a quart of oil. That should be good. Yep, it's good. Let's see. Got some gas in it. Okay, pull that out, turn the key on. See, the battery's dead. So, let's close the hood. burning belt somewhere. Or appears to be. Let me see. Oh, that's why. The idler is froze up, and unfortunately, I don't have one. And it's back ordered. So, what I'll do is give it the old lube and pray trick. It's getting there. Yeah, she'll be good. I'll just tell him he needs a belt and he needs an idler, but the idler is not available currently. The other idler is a little noisy. That one you could use a MTD pulley on. That's done. I'll take and put the side cover back on, and we'll give this guy his tractor back after I get the owning done. So, thanks for watching. I mean, we could do more, but you know, the guy's low on money, and you know how that is. So, All right, guys. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe. And see you on the next one. front of the block. So it definitely has some blow-by issues. Something I can't fix. He does have another engine sitting around for this thing. So my recommendation is to run until it blows. So, like I said, guys, that's my recommendation, is run it till it blows. So, she's got some problems. So, all right, guys, that's all for this one.